show to promote She Loves Me, and they You've heard of it? I wrote it.
Yeah. And she's like, I'll do the jokes. Just don't.
You did it too. And he pointed out my like physical resemblance to her, which I don't really see, but and then I saw nothing of it. It was just like a tiny, you know, it was like a bit. And then after the Republican National Convention, when she like famously plagiarized Michelle Obama's speech, they called me.
God.
I know, right?
It's like, what?
I actually feel bad for her, because obviously she didn't write it.
Some
idiot was like, just say this. And she was like, okay. And then the world like rained down a firestorm on her.
Well, they online bullied the person who was like, my whole platform is going to be to end online bullying.
Also, can we talk about the irony of her and the bullying?
I just cannot.
It's so funny to me. I'm like, here's your platform. Go into his bedroom, because you know they don't share a bed.
She didn't even live in the house for the first time.
Go into his bedroom and take his phone away.
Right.
End of platform! Proliferation of, like, you know, Fox News and Breitbart and these news sites that, if that's the only thing you watch or read, are actually very compelling. Like, if I thought that Hillary Clinton ran a child pornography ring out of a pizza place, I wouldn't vote for her either.
Right.
He is, like...
Sorry, Mandy, if you're here, I love you.
No, he's the best. I have a funny story about him. So
that's like how it always goes.
So he and Patty LaPone are really good friends, and I met him over and over again, and every time I met him, he'd be like, nice to meet you. And the 10th time he said that, Patty LaPone goes, if you say nice to meet you one more time, I'm going to set your balls on fire. I wrote to Manny Patinkin. He's like, he's a writer, he's a comedian, he's a serious actor, he's, you know, an author, he's a playwright, he's so many things. He's incredibly bright, really generous. He can't hear very well.
Oh, no.
Yeah, he has, I'm not sure what it's from. But so the first few times I was so nervous to be around him that all of my jokes were like under my breath. And he didn't respond. And I was like, oh my God, he hates me. And then finally he was like, he can't hear you. Like, if you want to make a joke, you have to say it loud.
Oh my God. Oh. You know, he wrote Bright Star.
Yeah, I'm not an
idiot. I know.
She's so generous. She's so funny. She's really, really smart. She was incredible to me. And that doesn't always happen. A lot of times, like, women and comedians, they can be a little rough to each other. And from the minute I met her, she was just cool. I really like her so much. And she's incredibly fast. She makes me look like a moron.
No way!
Oh, yeah, but she is so, so fast. I couldn't catch up. So she microwaves a joke. It was not good. But, so I had eaten all day, and she was like, do you want to go get a drink? And I was like, yes, have a drink. Do what? And she started out by saying to the bartender, she's like, I'll have 2 double vodkas on the rocks. I was like, I will also have 2 double vodkas on the rocks. And a loaf of bread. And I only remember the first like 30 to 40 minutes. I'm not a good drinker and I hadn't eaten them, and I don't remember how I got home. Not safe, nobody do that. Especially young people, don't do that. I just remember I woke up in the shower with my clothes and my shoes on.
Water off, though.
Water on?
Yeah, water on?
I was in the shower with my shoes on. Yeah, and my then husband opened the shower door and was like, what happened to you? And I looked up at him and I said, like the producers were saying that I didn't break my neck, and my doctor was like, yes, she did. And, but it was, like, we couldn't talk about it publicly, and it was just a weird thing. Like, the Post asked them why I was out, and they were like, we don't know, but we wish you joke for work. Meanwhile, I'm, like, a caller.
Like
my mom, like, baiting me. So, that was really hard for me. It was the first time in my life I ever felt like, oh, not everybody has your best interests at heart. Because I grew up in this tiny town where everybody was, like, rooting for me. So after that happened, I kind of lost my love for my first love, which is theater. It was just so physically painful and emotionally scarring. So I took a step back and I didn't do another show for a while. I did like a bunch of TV stuff, and then the next thing I did was The Wedding Singer, So thanks. And you know, I didn't feel particularly proud of my performance in The Wedding Singer. I didn't feel like I was like necessarily right for that part, even though I maybe tried my best. You know, not every role is your role.
Yeah.
They were so generous to cast me in it, and I did audition, and you know, it just ended up being like not the right fit. So I was feeling bad about that. So when Gypsy came along and I auditioned for that as well, once that came along and I felt a sense of community again, like I was able to talk about what happened to me with my neck, and people who had been pretty cruel to me reached out from the company to be like, oh my God, I'm so sorry.
Yeah.
So it felt like a healing of sorts, where I was brought back to the thing that I love to do, which is theater, you know?
I sold this TV idea to Sony.
Oh my God!
What is it? I can't really. I'm not allowed to talk about it. I'll tell you later. Yeah. But I'm trying to find right now like a showrunner for that show.
I'll do it.
Okay, great. I'm perfect. Hired. Done. So that